minutes ago, I finally completed the installation of our new Formica countertops on the kitchen cabinets here at the Border Fork. And I'd like to give you a run through of the process as it was done. It was the first time I had done a brand new set. I did refinish a countertop one time, but that was many years ago, and that was quite a challenge. But this is the first new installation that I've ever done. Now, these are Formica from Home Depot, and when they came to us, these edges here that you see right there, these side edges were open particle board. So on this one, which is where I started, I had to cut essentially a 2-foot piece and simply lay it up there, but I couldn't do that until after I had built up some underlayment, because you have to lift this up so there's not down blocking your drawer openings and that sort of thing. The instructions for underlayment talked about using a scrap or particle board or strand board. None of that made sense to me. I spent the money for some good pine 1x4s and discovered that these countertops were made to exactly fit that sort of thing. Now, the problem with much of this, well, this is not, I'm going to have to go over here to show you this. The problem with much of this was that it was necessary, I'm going to pull this, I think that maybe this one will work. Here we go. It was necessary to build up the width of a 1x4, and you can see in here that I actually have more than one layer. Here was the first one I put in. Then this layer here went on top of that. Only when that was all done was the countertop ready, or I mean was the underlayment ready for the countertop to be added. Now these screws that you see in there were all put in from the bottom up, because of course you don't want screws showing down through the Formica. Duh. Now, interestingly enough, when we got these Formica countertops, the long tops were a little bowed, a little warped up at the ends, and it was quite necessary, as you'll see in the hub I'm going to do, to put a lot of pressure on them to get them to match. Not over here on the short one, that was not a problem. The adding the sides here was a lot trickier than they'll admit. For one thing, you're supposed to iron them on, but before you do that, you need to make sure that there's extra wood or some kind of material under here built out so that it's level all the way down to support this side strip or end cap, as they're called. I did that in a variety of ways, ignoring the instructions. The instructions and the material they sent with the packages made no sense to me at all. I could not make head nor tails of them. So I just started and used what common sense I could find and built from there. Now, once they're put on, you have to iron them on. It's a chemical reaction kind of glue with a 300 to 350 degree iron. Had to go buy the iron to do that. And then they're not even at that point. You have ragged edges up here. Around in over here, there's some extra material that you don't need. They do that so that they have enough. This forward thing didn't really fit naturally, but it stuck out. I found out that you could break them cleanly as long as you're going in and, you know, don't make the mistake of trying to pull it out, because that would not be the brightest thing to do. They talk about either using a file or sanding this down. I have an 8-inch bastard file that worked very, very well for that, and I also used it to push where I wanted to break the edge of the Formica. Now, another thing that they do not tell you is that if you get a file down to where it's all smooth and everything, it's pretty ugly if you leave the seam exposed, because sometimes the seam's not exactly just a single straight line, and also it stands out more than you'd like. All that was done to take care of that in this case was to grab a Sharpie, a black Sharpie, because of the color here, a black Sharpie, and just run a line of ink right down there, rub it in a little bit with the finger, and done. Now, there were a couple of cases where I had to tack a nail in through the formica because the glue simply, heat or no heat, would not set properly or strongly enough. Now, in those cases, you wouldn't want to try to do this if you were a contractor building for someone else, but in our case, it really doesn't matter. There aren't that many of them, and they're not that visible. We're looking right smack at a couple of them right now, and they really don't stand out that much. Most of them are fine. There's nothing on the far edge of this one. There are a couple of nails on this one, a couple one over in that small set of cabinets that I just was over at a minute ago, and none over here at all on the sink situation. The trickiest part of all, of course, was cutting in the hole for the double sink. We used a jigsaw for that. It was very, very scary because there is no room for error in this thing. Got very lucky. I can't ascribe it to much more than that. Yes, care. I don't know about skill because it was my first time doing it, but this thing is actually like a press fit. It didn't require any clamping down at all to get it solid. It's in there. You can't move this thing no matter how hard you push this way or this way. It's not going to go. You could reach down in and yank it out of there, but of course, we don't really want to do that. I'm not even going to add clamps to this one because the way the clamps are designed for this, they won't fit. It just won't work. So be careful of that when you're checking a sink, that you've got a functional kind of clamping system, unless you intend to be as lucky as we were there. Well, that's kind of a review. We'll just go back around here one last time. This is our, well, let's back up and get kind of an overview of how the kitchen looks now. Backing up. So there you see, just panning around like this, getting as far back as we can without falling out the door here. And we're gaining. One of these days, we're actually going to have a functional kitchen. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed.